Good morning and welcome in activity 2, mitosis. At the end of this video, you will be able to define mitosis, describe in details what happens in each phase of mitosis, and deduce that mitosis ensures the maintenance of the biological identity of the cell. In order to grow, develop, and to repair damaged tissue, there is a process where one cell becomes two cells, four cells, and thousands of other cells. This type of cell division and proliferation is known as mitosis. So can you remember the phases of mitosis? Let's see throughout this video. In order for the cell to divide, it must pass through something known as the cell cycle, where mitosis is a small part of it. And if you remember the phases of mitosis correctly, you will say that mitosis is made up of four phases: prophase, metaphase, anaphase, and telophase. The rest part of the cell cycle is known as interphase. During interphase, you will find this cell containing chromatin fibers. In interphase, the cell prepares itself for division. However, interphase is not our issue here. For now, we must concentrate on the phases of mitosis only. To do so, we will show you the phases of mitosis, and it's your job to write down what's happening in each phase. So prepare yourselves. And let's start by prophase. Let's see if you described prophase correctly. During prophase, chromatin condenses into chromosomes. Nuclear envelope disintegrates or disappears, as you're seeing here. Those centrosomes duplicate into two asters, and finally, spindle fibers start to appear between those two asters. Let's continue on with the second phase, metaphase. Don't forget to take notes and to describe the steps. Now, as you've seen during metaphase, chromosomes align in the middle of the cell on the equator or in something called the metaphase plate. What do you think will happen during anaphase? Well, as you've seen throughout anaphase, the centromere of each chromosome will divide into two centromeres, allowing each chromatid to separate. Now, the two separated chromatids will move towards the opposite poles. Moving towards opposite poles is known as polar ascension. This separation or movement to opposite poles will allow the two identical sets of chromosomes, for example, the blue ones here, to be found at each pole of the cell. I hope that you've recognized those steps during anaphase when watching the video. Now going on to the last step, telophase. Now for telophase, the nuclei reform, the nuclear membrane and the nucleolus around genetic material. The chromosomes uncoil or return on being chromatin. The asters become centrosomes. The spindle fibers disappear, and the cytoplasm of the cell constricts, or in other terms, divides. This cleavage here is known as constriction. In short, during telophase, everything returns to its original state. Presence of a nuclear membrane, decondensed chromatin, presence of centrosomes, and the disappearance of the spindle fibers. When all the phases of mitosis are over, cytokinesis occurs to separate each cell from one another. Now, let's note an important idea. If we compare the number of chromosomes in the mother cell and in the daughter cells, we will find that they are equal. 4 chromosomes in the mother cell and 4 chromosomes in each daughter cell. For us humans, those 3 cells will contain 46 chromosomes or 2N. Then we can conclude that mitosis ensures the maintenance of the biological identity of an individual, where the number of chromosomes is conserved. However, there is one important thing to note here. The mother cell contains 4 chromosomes, but every chromosome is made up of 2 sister chromatids. And for the daughter cells, each chromosome is made up of only 1 chromatid. How is this possible? How do we have only 1 chromatid? It is obvious to think that the solution is in interphase. Because we said that the cell cycle is made up of 2 parts, interphase and mitosis, where interphase represents the preparation phase and mitosis represents the division phase. So to sum up, in this video you've learned about the phases of mitosis, starting by prophase, where mainly the nuclear membrane disintegrates, chromosomes are condensed, and asters and spindle fibers start to form. Metaphase, where chromosomes are lined up on the equatorial plate, anaphase, where sister chromatids separate, and finally, telophase, where everything returns to its original state. Also, don't forget that both mother and daughter cells have the same chromosomal number, which is 2N. Then, our genetic material is maintained. So this is how to imagine our cells after mitosis.
Where is Gus? You all look the same!
However, the difference is that at the beginning of mitosis, each chromosome is of 2 chromatids, while we end up with daughter cells containing chromosomes with only 1 chromatid. How? This will be our discussion in the next lesson. For now, let's recall mitosis events altogether.
An adult human contains an estimated 100 trillion cells, and yet we start life as a single cell. To grow, develop, and repair tissue damage, we rely on cell division. In eukaryotic cells, this process is accomplished by a series of well-orchestrated steps called mitosis. Every day our bodies must produce millions of skin cells to replace those lost through normal activity. Each of these cells must have a complete complement of the genetic material. The cell is now ready to go through mitosis, which consists of prophase, metaphase, anaphase, and telophase. During prophase, the chromosomes condense and become visible, appearing as 2 sister chromatids held together at the centromere. The cytoskeleton disassembles as the spindle begins to form. In animal cells, centrioles play an important role in the distribution of the chromosomes in the dividing cell. The centrioles migrate to opposite poles, establishing a bridge of microtubules called the spindle apparatus, and the nuclear envelope breaks down. Towards the end of prophase, chromosomes attach, by proteins in their centromeres called kinetochores, to microtubules from each pole, moving the chromosomes toward the equator of the cell. During metaphase, all chromosomes are aligned at the equator of the cell, called the metaphase plate. Anaphase begins with the degradation of proteins that hold sister chromatids together, freeing individual chromosomes. The free chromosomes are then pulled by their kinetochores to opposite poles. At telophase, a cleavage furrow forms in the center of the cell. This indentation is made from a constricting belt of actin filaments surrounding the inside of the cell's circumference. Chromosomes cluster at opposite poles and begin decondensing as the nuclear envelope reforms around them. The spindle apparatus disassembles. In animal cells, cytokinesis completes cell division by extending the cleavage furrow to completely separate the newly formed daughter cells.
This video is prepared by teacher Isra Abdul Rasool, recorded by teacher Zahra Shiri, and supervised by teacher Ehsan Hash Hassan. Thank you for your time.